So good morning. Today's experiment is related to impact test by Charpy method. So let us see the striker of the Charpy method. This is the striker of the Charpy test, wherein the striker is in this manner. Clear? So this we are able to see a small sharp edge at the one side and another a wide edge at another edge. So this type of striker will be there for the Charpy testing of impact testing. So how to fix this? We need to understand that whenever we are fixing, this point should be towards the specimen. So this point will hit the specimen on this side such a way that we have to fix the particular Charpy test striker. So how is the specimen? So now coming to the specimen, specimen is Charpy, where we can see a U type groove is provided. So in U type groove, we can easily see that this groove is having totally, this groove is up to half part. So how to provide this particular thing? So this will be on the simply supported manner, such that here the two supports will be there in this way if I want to show. So this is the groove, I'll just turn it in this way and on this direction. Okay, so we can see the groove is in this format. Clear? Now being the groove in that format, the striker will be going to come and hit in this direction. So we need to understand the striker is going to hit at the exactly midpoint of the specimen. Here this will be going to come and hit, so this will be falling and striker is going to hit in this way. So that is known as the Charpy. So in this manner we need to place this striker to the impact testing machine, and also we have to place this member in the simply supported form. So let us go towards the instrument and do the experiment. See, related to Charpy test, as we have seen that impact testing machine consists of Charpy as well as iJod. So in the Charpy, again one division is equals to 2 joules. So here the external circle we have to consider for the Charpy test, internal circle we have to consider for the iJod test. Okay, so in Charpy we comes the readings from 0 to 300 joules. Readings in the Charpy is from 0 to 300 joules. Okay, so now this way. So this testing machine is now elevated. The pendulum is elevated to 140 degrees. So this is the vertical and this is the pendulum. So this angle makes 140 degrees. Now here we need to find out first without specimen. Without specimen we need to check this particular pendulum is to be locked here properly. This locking is to be made. Then we need to set this dial gauge at 300 joules so that we find out any corrections. So what is the correction factor? First we are going to find out. So please just elevate this from this side. Be away from this and also be away from the pendulum line, otherwise it will make harm for us. Either we are going to have a damage with our body parts. So this pendulum, so we have to be away from the pendulum striking. So now I am going to release the latch such that pendulum will show the reading. So this much is the pendulum is going to wave. We have to stop such that it makes its own weight such that it get reduced, or apply small amount of braking system. When we apply small amount of braking system, we can make the pendulum to stop easily. It can get stopped. Now, once the pendulum is stopped, we need to note down the reading. Here we can see one division. One division means 2 joules of correction is required. We are going to note down that reading such that 2 joules is the correction factor. So, 2 joules is the correction factor, we are making it in the reading part. Stop model. So, now the pendulum is placed at 140 degrees, reading is at 300 joules, okay, and specimen is placed like a simply supported. For being conscious, I have just kept the specimen here. The specimen, we can see the groove is on the other side and the striker is going to hit in this way, okay. So, this is the particular specimen what we have placed at the specimen point, okay. Now we will release the pendulum. So let us see the pendulum part. Here we are going to release. Okay, so this pendulum we are going to release this particular part.
Lock.
So remove the lock and remove the jack. Applying the brake, we need to stop the particular pendulum to fall from the thing. So now we can see here the joules have came up to 8 number of readings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 into 2 means 16 joules. 16 joules is the reading what we are going to note down. So, make this pendulum to stop. Once the pendulum is stopped, so I will show the broken specimen which was broken into two pieces. Here is the one piece and one more piece is here striked out. Totally this we can see the specimen is broken into two pieces after it is hitting from the back side. So this specimen is broken and we have got the reading as 16 joules by 8 into 2. One division is equals to 2 joules, so that is 8. So 8 into 2, that is particularly 16 joules. So let us go for the calculation part.